Hi. Welcome back to the PageFly video tutorial series named What PageFly Can Do. In this video, I will guide you on how to build a complete product page in PageFly.
To fast forward, you can click on the timestamp here to jump between each step.
I will build a page based on this page from Mack Weldon website. Before we begin, we need to take a quick analysis of the Mack Weldon product page. You can see that this is a simple, clean page, yet fully detailed information like shipping policy, pricing, key features, and so on. In the buy section, we have a common half layout here. On the left, there is product images and a quick description of the product's features. On the right, we have two parts, a product detail block and a material block. Now, in the product detail block, there is a review element and a color swatch. These elements aren't available in PageFly yet, so you need to use three third-party apps for that. In this video, I will use judge.me for the review feature and product personalizer by Zepto for the color swatch function. To understand further how the design of this page is made, you can right-click and select Open Inspector. Here, you can find out about the font, the color swatch, and the spacing that Mack Weldon uses. You can copy and paste it into a notepad for reference. Now, to save time when building a page, I will config the font family and the color in the theme settings. Here, I will change the font heading to Montserrat, and the body text font a Lotto.
This way, PageFly page will inherit the theme's font. Alternatively, you can also choose other fonts, or upload your own in PageFly.
Alright, now let's head to PageFly and create a new product page. In the page settings, I will hide the theme's default by section and assign the page to our polo shirts. Now I will drag and drop the product detail element in the editor. By default, the max width of a section in PageFly is set to 1170px, which is quite narrow when compared to our reference layout. So I will increase it a little bit. I will also change the background color of this section. Now, we're going to fine-tune each part of this section. First of all, I will design the layout of the product image. The next item is the product features part. I will use the slideshow element for this section. Delete the unnecessary elements and add an image to each slide. I will add a left margin to this element so that it will align with the product image. In this case, I will use the percentage number so that the margin fits well on every device type. Moving on to the right side, this part will have two parts, a product detail block, and a material block. Then we need to create two blocks for it. I will move these elements inside the proper block. I will add the rating star element to this section. You can easily do this by heading to the Add Third Party Element button, find the element you need, and drag and drop it to the product page. I will also delete the default product element and replace it with the product personalizer by Zepto, who add a color swatch to our product page. Now let's add the shipping policy and the afterpay paragraph to the page. You can edit and add the link to the shipping policy in the general tab. Thank you.
The Afterpay line is a little tricky since it has a paragraph and an image in the same line. You will have to add another block element, add the paragraph and the image into this block. Then select Styling, Display, Flex, Wrap, choose Wrap. To make the button full width separate from the product quantity selector, select the button, go to Styling and move to the CSS code parameter, add Width 100% to make the button full width. Now, let's style each element like the reference design. Then, again, you can open the inspector to precisely duplicate the style of Mack Weldon page. For the materials and care block, I will add a heading and a list element to it. You can also change the icon of the list. To make the icon and the text align vertically, I will increase the margin right of some list icons. The next section is simpler than the previous one. I will add a full width section. Now, let's create another column next. Let's add image and content. I will add it as a background image of a column. This will give me more flexibility when cropping the image. Finally, let's style the section like our reference design. With this section, let's add another full width layout. Add a heading and a product list in it. In the product list, you can click on the product image to configure the hover action and turn on product badge. Set the condition for the badge to show up on the live view. In this case, I will choose the condition, when a product contains a staff pick tag, a badge will show up. You can add the tag to your products in Shopify Admin. Add a half layout to your page. Now let's add an image to the left. On the right column, to add the paragraph and the icon in the same line, you will have to add a block element, add the paragraph and the image into this block. Then select Styling, Display, Flex, Wrap, choose Wrap. Then select Align Items, choose Center to make the icon and the paragraph align center. Let's style the section like our reference design. To make the content align center, please select the row and change the content position. Lastly, let's add a review section in the editor and publish it. For the mobile version, we need to readjust the padding and margin of them. Notice that if we adjust a parameter to have a mobile icon on the left, the change won't affect other versions. In this section, you can see that on the mobile version, the text appears first, before the image, unlike our reference design. To reverse this hierarchy, select the row, go to Styling, Display, Flex, select Wrap Reverse. I will continue to adjust other sections to make sure every displays properly on desktop and mobile. Thank you. This is the end of the video tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel to get more new video tutorials. These are other videos on our channel you also may need. Thanks for watching.